When HEART began, again, our focus was HIV/AIDS prevention. And then when we began teaching that, after the first year, we realized, okay, we had to add the opportunistic diseases, TB, malaria, typhoid, hepatitis B. And so that is still our focus, to saturate rural Kenya with these prevention messages. But while we were up country and teaching in these villages, we saw the AIDS orphans, we saw the widows, we saw, you know, teaching like down in the Maasai area, and I'm teaching the importance of washing their face and keeping the flies away from their children's eyes and health issues. And so we got involved in some water projects and partnered with Rotary. And then we found, you know, these widows that were dying in the slums. We do home-based care, and here they are. And we could help them if we could start some kind of project, and at the same time needed bed nets up country. So that's how we started the wheat projects. And now this circle begins to get bigger, and you have these spokes. One is water, one is wheat projects, one is uniforms. We're giving away, call it Kids for School, boat and a uniform, and to kids up country. And another spoke of the wheel is orphan and vulnerable children, that maybe that includes some of the orphanages like Bridges that we go to. It's an orphan prevention. We put it all under an umbrella called COPE, Community Orphan Prevention Through Education. We're educating the mom on how to have a job to take care of her own children. And then we're educating the children by giving them uniforms and they're able to go to school. So education has always been the key of HEART. Knowledge equals power equals survival. So the wheel got bigger with more spokes, and then we tried to find partners. When you look at the wheel, you'll see the partners in between, like Caris Foundation and the Norris Rugel Foundation, Rotary, churches, individual sponsors. Those are the ones. CDC helps us with our VCTs up country. So that's how the wheel keeps going. But the main thing, when you look at the wheel, you'll see at the top says HEART teams. The wheel doesn't roll, nothing continues without HEART teams. So HEART teams are our main avenue of how this rolls through Kenya. We've got footprints all over Kenya, HEART does, because HEART teams have gone there, it's their footprints. Because malaria is such a huge issue down here. 700,000 children die in East Africa from malaria, and usually within their first 4 years of life. That's why World Health says if children under 5 should all be sleeping under a bed net. And if they did, we could save up to 50% of these children from malaria.
We, as women of the WIP, we were not happy. We were discriminated because of our status. We thought that that was the end of our life, because there's no point that somebody can be neglected from the community. You are sick, you've nothing to do, you've got no future, you're just there dumped, waiting to die.
So these women were in absolute desperate, down to the bottom situations. And to come back up and now learning a trade, having food on their table every night, their kids are all in school, help with their medication, and the hope that they are going to be able to totally be self-sustaining. They just can't really believe that this is happening for them, you know, that this is something that they're enjoying, that they're getting to have this opportunity in life. And we call it the WIP Center because I honestly felt I could hear women in Kenya crying for their children. How am I going to support my children? And I could, it's really, I know it sounds strange, but it's like at night sometimes when I crawl into my nice comfortable bed and get ready to go to sleep, I can hear them crying. Who's going to help me with my children? And when you'd visit them in their home and they're dying, always they would grab my hand and always they had the same thing. Mama, help my children. So I feel the key is keep mom alive and keep her alive, and not only alive but working, and able to provide for her own. No one can take care of your children better than you can as a mom. The cycle of life. This isn't a cycle of death. We always think of death when we think of AIDS. It can be a cycle of life with just a little bit of help. So I'm looking for more people that would give $50 a month to help these centers. They can designate the center. They want to help the center in Mombasa. They want to help one in Mathari slums. They want to help Incubira slums. You know, if they've been here and seen it, they can help in the center they want to help. They can start a brand new center for $4,000 and then help me raise the $50 a month to keep it going for the first at least 6 months. And then they're making enough, you know, they can make it on their own. Same time we started the Kids for School project, which is children up country. Most all of these are raised by grandma up country. Mom and dad have died from AIDS. They're up country. They aren't able to go to school because they don't have a uniform. And what happens is then this child gets a uniform and a goat, and we got a grant for that. So we had these children that we could help, and I thought, wow, instead of buying the uniforms, we'll start 3 more WEEP centers, and those women can make the uniforms for the Kids for School project. So it's kind of in this cycle to help these women get out of poverty. But we got to do this 100 goats and uniforms, and it was so exciting to see that. But what was sad is in that area we did 100, and they had identified 836 that qualified. And I told them you could choose 100 out of 836. So some of these that weren't chosen, the grandmas came up to me, making sure that I personally saw their child that was not in school, and that please can we also do their child? Can't we please get a uniform for their child so they can go back to school? I couldn't make a promise because I don't know if I'm going to be able to help their child. It's cost about $65 really for the uniform and a goat, and that's a complete uniform. That's the uniform, that's the sweater that they're supposed to have that identifies what school they go to, the shoes, the socks, the undergarments, and a milking goat. So it's a deal. It's a real deal. Well, we have funding for the uniforms. The centers themselves, we need to seek more funding. It's just too small. The center itself is too small. It's all I can afford. But I need 2 rooms like that for those women, and spread them out a little bit for health reasons. So we need more money for rent, for electricity, for space, for the opportunistic diseases that we're treating, because the ARVs that are given free, the AIDS medication, is only for the AIDS medication. They don't give them anything else. There's nothing supportive in that. She has to try to find the funds for that, so we assist with that part.